Hello and welcome everyone to American Truck Simulator on a Thursday night. Yes, I know it seems a little bit odd. Normally I would do something VR related, but I do have a little bit of a sad announcement. For the temporary time, I am unable to do VR due to my headset. Well, not my headset particularly, but the microphone that is attached to my headset itself, unfortunately, frayed a wire, so... Yeah, we get that every once in a while, too. It disconnects, reconnects, so I apologize if that happens. If it keeps doing that, I will physically completely unplug it, but... Oh, well, it's gonna be doing what it's gonna be doing, am I right? anyways... getting back to the show, hopefully you're all enjoying your Thursday into Friday, depending on your providence, and we are closing in on the New Year's, and I do hope, with everything going on, that Saturday, I will get my other microphone in and we'll be able to do a Saturday night stream VR, where we will visit all sorts of our people for the New Year's. And maybe even play all the sign. Who knows? Anyways, I am in my VC. I'm going to undeafen, and yeah. Lags Lord Fartbubble themselves has joined the chat. Lovely, lovely. Always stinking up the chat, aren't you?
So... As soon as you unmuted, Lags joined and that did a double fucking noise.
Oh, damn, we got a double hammer on there. Double hammer time.
ATS tonight, huh?
Yes, because, well, as I announced earlier, unfortunately...
Oh, I haven't seen that yet.
I just said it in stream. No VR until the new microphone comes in. So, yeah.
I mean, I did suggest to Jack we try VCD, but,
What's that?
Visceral cleanup gel.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I gifted you guys that.
Mm-hmm. But I don't have it downloaded as a thing. So.
It's like three...
around it right now.
It's like three different things. It's the base game with, like, two DLC, I think.
Yeah, I didn't download the DLCs. I'm just running the base game for right now.
Yeah.
So...
Oh yeah, I do have your PayPal, Jack.
Ah, okay.
Jack, I will be joining you here in a moment.
Roger.
If you have a server up that is.
I do not. I am gonna be doing more quick jobs this round.
Do you want me to set one up then?
If you want to, we can. You can, yes.
Alright, let me...
And Lags, in VCD, I'm down in the sewers right now.
I haven't really done much of it yet. Oh...
Also, I figured out how to find the codes for the doors. After you complete a level, you'll be sent to the office area, and there'll be some locked doors. Once you find the code, you gotta find out where the numbers sit. To do that, you can do like 1111 and whatnot until you hear the code chirp out. But every time a number is in the correct position, the screen will flash white. You take down the numbers where the screen flashes white, in the order that they appear in that way, and you got the code.
Let's go.
Trying to think of a good code name.
Ah, damn it. Corvette. Or Camaro. My bad.
You started a job already?
It's just gonna be a very quick job.
Alright.
Like, literally, it's, I think it's like 10 miles.
Turn left.
And to be fair, the base game of BCD was very quick to download.
Stay right, then exit right.
Oh, hello, Angel! Does it feel like work yet? No, this is not work because I am much happier doing this kind of towing and trucking than some of the stuff that I've been having to get into. Also, that Jeep was out on bombing run, Jesus Christ.
Let's see. I now have... What state is this? What? Okay, that's California.
Also, is it saying that it's... Jesus Christ, is that far away?
I have Colorado.
Oh.
What?
Shit. Job market. GPS is. Oh, it already expired. Never mind.
So I have unlocked 3 more states. I have Colorado, the state above and next to Arizona, which I think this state is because it has a thing called Grand Canyon Village.
Utah.
Probably. It doesn't tell me the names of all the states, and I didn't pay enough attention in, or I didn't have whatever kind of thing you would be, what kind of class you'd be in to study the states and know where they all are. If I had a geography, yeah, I didn't have geography. If I had a world map in front of me right now, I could probably
figure out. I'll be doing amazing.
What state it was.
Hello, Blaster. I'm doing okay. Just a little bit of ATS tonight. We're just gonna be doing quick little hop loads because, well, it is already past midnight and I'm not gonna do a very long stream tonight. Reason being, shit.
I'm guessing you got home not long ago.
I got home a little bit ago, but I had a shower and then I had some BS I had to do, unfortunately. And I need to recalibrate my wheel.
Nice. Yay, gotta love the recalibrate.
At least it does it quickly, so. There we go. Recalibrated. Alright. And...
Oh, no, I was right. Okay, so I have California, Nevada, Utah, Colorado, and New Mexico.
Alright, so I'm in Laramie. This is a large reservoir tank. I pay $6,000 versus this one, which both of them go into Rollins, Wyoming. This one pays more. This guy, it's a little further. We'll go with this guy because I'm pretty sure I'll be able to, You are about to set for a heavy haul. Review your current truck configuration. This parameter is essential for heavy cargo transport. Yeah.
Duly noted. If I press spacebar, it activates the,
Okay, so I can't do a HIFS one because it is a heavy haul. Unfortunately.
And you can't do heavy hauls?
I don't have a powerful enough truck yet.
So you'd have to rent one.
And I'm not one for renting trucks.
Fair enough. Well, I do have a server up.
Okay, let's find a new route.
Alright, give me 1 second, I will join your server. Alright. Convoys, continue. And I presume it's fart bubble?
Yes.
It could also be the Squeakinator.
No, it's not. It's a different password this time.
Okay, well, 1 moment. I will use my BRB screen so that way they don't see it.
Yeah.
Then you can DM it to me really quick and I'll be able to go from there.
Beep, 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 beep. Deep, beep, 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 deep.
Now, I'm going to presume it's all caps or all lowercase?
All lowercase.
All lowercase?
No space.
Okay. Roger that.
I'm messaging someone right now about doing some work for someone.
Hello, Javi, and hello, Wantomek. I think that's how you pronounce my name. The name there. I apologize if I am wrong.
Javi the cutie.
I know Javi the cutie. I talk to them fairly commonly. It's the new person Wantomek, I want to say. I apologize if I'm not pronouncing
it. Oh, hi, Shmoopy. Welcome to hell.
Little Rue here?
Yes, they can talk with good internet now.
Woo!
Yay!
Alright, so I am...
Although we can't hear you, I don't know if you're talking or not, but we can't hear you.
I am heading to the Grand Canyon Village.
Grand Canyon Village? Alright. So I am now in. We're going to roll in this peat, which we have in psychedelic. Pronunciation is correct. Wantomek. Okay. Thank you thank you for helping me on out. World of map. You are... Alright, I'm over by Cheyenne. You're all the way down here. And... Looks like I have to go to Flagstaff if I want to, or maybe Kingman.
Shmoopy, are you on the wrong mic?
Oh my
god!
You
sound
so distant!
Oh my god! So quiet! Sounds so cute!
You sound like
Why
is Shmoopy underwater? Who's trying to drown the child?
No, it's they don't like sound like they're underwater. It sounds like they're wrapped up in a tight blanket.
Sounds like they're in the walls.
I'll let you out. Hold up, I know how to get you out. You'll just burst through like the Kool-Aid man. I have a milkshake in my hand.
Okay.
If
Tom, okay. Roger that. I will call you Tom then. Yes, Angel, it is a definite all moment.
But are you on the right mic, Shmoopy?
Just check the other settings!
No!
He's sounds like my neighbor's having a fight.
Oh my god!
Why is it doing this? Are you on your iPad? Why is it doing this on your iPad?
What the hell?
They might have their iPad mic pressed into the blanket or something.
No, literally, okay, I have my headphones on right here. And my,
You might have some sort of crud in there, which is why we can't hear you very well.
Ready to roll.
I have Shmoopy turned up to 200 and I'm still having trouble hearing them.
Turn right, and then turn left.
Wait, try leaving and joining. Maybe that's it.
Turn left.
Try speaking.
I don't hear them at all.
Oh my gosh, I had you at 200.
Oh no, I'm sorry.
It's fine. Okay.
Just lag said, oh, you can't hear them at all, and I'm like, no! Okay, am I better now or no?
Way better.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Oh,
thank God. We can hear you perfectly.
Thank God, I've been freed from the wall.
Yeah, I guess it just took the threat of a hammer.
And a milkshake.
Yeah, dude, what the heck is in the wall? Why is there... Hot Rod, why are there like 6 controllers stuck in your wall?
Wait.
We're not gonna talk about that.
Hold on, I didn't see this, excuse me?
Well, I was stuck in Hot Rod's wall, which definitely is...
Well, why were you even in the wall in the first place?
I don't know. I spawned weird.
Meister boss, Meister.
Now, Jackie, the wall shadow got them.
Most games will spawn you in game. Also, Shmoopy and Lucy, I hope you both enjoyed that photo of the cheese curds.
Cheese curds.
Yeah, I also got the white cheddar ones too.
Oh yeah, that's right. You're up in that area where you eat like cheese curds. I forget that.
Yo,
the Midwest.
Fried, though. They're not
yes.
fried.
Canada.
The cheese curds don't have to be fried.
I know, but these are the less fattening ones because they're not deep fried.
Yo.
They're just 1% less fat.
Also, I forgot how loud my chair is. Anytime I move, my mic picks it up.
Oh, geez. That's funny.
Yeah.
Mine does it too.
So
I might just switch over to my bed or something, so I'm not accidentally just like.
So I didn't estimate the amount of money that I had to give my dad for rent for this paycheck. So I'm having my dad put $150 back in my account tomorrow when he gets paid, and then I just have to give him the $150 my next paycheck. So then I can get the fucking hard drive.
Yeah.
Because I need more space.
Dude, so to fix my computer, I need to get an SSD, right? Lucy helped me find one, and I'm gonna order a 2 terabyte one for like 57% off, and I'm like, yo, it's like literally the price of like 1 terabyte, and it's awesome. But I was gonna order it. I was asking for the Amazon login. My mom was like, oh no, I don't want you on the Amazon account right now because like there's like just shit on there. I don't want you to see. And plus, she's gonna order it for me as a Christmas gift, but she hasn't ordered it yet. And I'm like, please. Just order it, otherwise it's gonna come like hella late, and please. She's like, I wanna double check and make sure it's the right one, and like see if there's any that are gonna be the exact same that'll like come sooner. And I'm like, that's cool, but can you do that as soon as possible? Cause like right now my entire social life is online and I don't have like access to 70% of the things I do.
That is so
I'm also very excited.
I'm trying to remember what button on the controller it was to turn. Oh, it's already off.
I feel like I might have actually scared a few people with the ominous thing I did by saying a special broadcast.
Yeah, I was like, are you gonna like announce something? What is happening? And then you're like, hello! And I'm like, oh, okay.
No, that's not actually far from the truth. Okay, listen.
Listen, I could have, like, if I had, like, the VTuber thing going on, I could have just had my, like, my Sona holding two milkshakes, like, I got milkshakes, bitches, and then just end stream. That's when the announcement is.
That's the announcement. I'm switching over to my bed, so every little movement I make isn't, sounding like a bitch.
Oh.
I couldn't find the words for it. Also, I got a ferret onesie for Christmas.
Nice.
I'm wearing it right now. It's poggers.
I got some nice PJs.
Yo.
Oh, man. Disaster. I had a smoopy, they say, and they're back on break. They also have a cheer, so everybody get yourself some drink, whether it be chocolate, smuggers, or makeup, make taste a man in a can, Mountain Dew amp. So, bottoms up.
I will cover my whole mouth over the whole, like, cup that I have consumed.
Dude, I also got two awesome cups for Christmas.
We're wanting to do just quick jobs, right?
Yeah, little short hoppers.
Okay, let me...
Oh, my thing fell asleep. Actually, I could probably just tune in the stream and just mute it, I was gonna say.
Yeah.
But then also, I have a delay and shit. But anyway, I'll just do that.
Hi.
Hello, Twitch. Where are you? Thank you. Oh god, I hear myself. Shut up.
That's how I feel.
Dude, okay, I'll talk about this in another stream I was watching. Hearing yourself echo just totally throws you off of building any sentence, because then your brain is like, I'm hearing myself, I'm hearing myself, I'm hearing myself, and you're like, stop it!
You know what? There's an app out there called Speech Jammer, and it does just that. And someone suggested that we try doing squads with Speech Jammer, and I said, God. You won't be a sadistic little fuck, don't you?
You? Dude, I hope you banned that person.
No, I said... No, but we'll let you run Speech Jammer on your own and see how that goes. I got a 3-liter Termos and a floor chair. Ooh. I mean, when I hear my own voice, I sound nasally and as horrible. Yeah.
If I can hear my own voice, I just turn on Hear Yourself on Voice Mod Pro.
Ugh. I dislike my voice, and I know everyone's like, oh man, I love your voice, your voice is great. I know it's great, but I personally hate it. Because, like, 50% of the time, people think I sound like a 12-year-old boy, and then the other 50%, people are like, girl, and I'm like, stop it.
Yes. Anyone who says that again, I will literally, like, jam, like... I don't know, like, I will stab them with a cup.
I will throw a DVD... I will throw a DVD copy of Alvin and the Chipmunks the Squeakquel at them if they do it again.
Also, my girlfriend is messaging me and is like, where are your fucking Pringles at? And I'm like, I'll bite you. Don't touch my Pringles.
No! Mine!
If they keep trying to find your Pringles, marry them, and then divorce them, because they're trying to steal your Pringles.
Oh, Disaster says they gotta get a voice mod. Well, if you get a voice mod or something that has some sort of voice modulation to it, then you'll be able to do all kinds of neat and wonderful stuff, just like this. Or even this, if you want to go back to the old days.
Or even this.
Or you could even do this.
God damn it!
Or just have microphone problems like I do.
Taking me forever, Jack.
God damn it with your PlayStation!
Yo, the PlayStation.
Hey, I'm waiting on you, Lag.
Also, Disaster, you don't know this, but Roxy, my ferret, has searched up Justin Bieber 2 separate times when she slams on the keyboard. I don't know why, but somehow I don't know how, twice on 2 separate occasions, not even the same device. It wasn't even like search history or anything. It was
How do I lock? I don't know if this is the right trailer, but I think it is. How do I lock it on my thing?
On keyboard, it's T.
Also,
why is it showing you not having a job? What the hell?
I thought, what the heck? I don't
no,
have a job.
No, that's me. I'm unemployed.
When did I get fired?
I don't fucking know.
Shmoopy, remember that one time in VR chat whenever I was playing the war, he eats shampoo in the shower and fucking dies, and you were just dying?
You were just dying. It was so funny.
It was. I felt kind of bad because I thought you were going to wake up.
Did you accept the job?
Dude, I was going to cardiac arrest. It
just said GPS destination didn't let me accept the job.
You have to go out.
Wait, you got arrested?
No, I went into cardiac arrest. It's very different.
Boo. You have to go to the front out there where their trailer is, and you have to enter in. Then once you enter in, you'll be able to take the job. And once you do that, I'll be able to join in off of you. So.
Also, guys.
Very much so.
Roxy got a comfy little bed for Christmas, and she's been sleeping in it all day.
Good.
Nice.
I got a microwave popcorn maker, which I have yet to use.
Microwave popcorn maker? You mean a microwave?
No, it's a bowl that you put popcorn kernels in and stick in the microwave.
Okay, because you said microwave popcorn maker, and I'm like, that's a microwave.
I have
a popcorn bowl.
You know, I have a stove, and I put butter in it, and I cook popcorn that way. It's better.
But
I don't think you're supposed to put butter in the stove, but
I will drink the butter.
Yeah.
Oh, please don't.
The game is actually not as complex as you think, Disaster of all things. It's
please don't throw Rick Shades and eat things that you shouldn't be eating.
It's a lot easier when you have a steering wheel and a shifter.
And I will enjoy it.
Plus it has prompts.
I believe I started a job.
In our living room, which is kind of made like a home theater, it's cool. We have a popcorn maker, but then we also have a stovetop popcorn pan thing with a little like handle you crank and it turns the popcorn so it doesn't burn.
That's strange. I'm looking in the convoy.
Disaster, what the hell did you say?
It's not showing you as having a job still.
By the way, happy birthday, Disaster.
I haven't picked up the trailer yet.
Well, oh yeah! Some macaroni.
It's still showing you as just showing you as idle.
I have a job and I'm at the place right now. I just
also Shmoopy, speaking of like onesies, I want to get an otter like onesie. I want to be an otter with the dark side.
Do it. Also, quality video, Disaster.
Oh, I need to see the video. Is it funny?
It was such quality. It was good. It was a ferret. I almost said it was a goose, but that was the ferret's name. It was a ferret that was playing in macaroni.
Oh, I need to see that really bad for... I need to see that for scientific reasons. I'm a scientist.
Disaster, you know what you must do.
The GPS told me to fucking come.
Sometimes I have dreams that my desk is made out of cake and I want to just eat it when I wake up.
Yeah, that's...
One time I had a dream where I was at a tea party with a bunch of dogs who were barking with British accents.
What? Bark with the British accents?
They were like, rrr, and I'm like, what is happening?
Yeah, it's not showing,
It doesn't tell me to accept. What am I supposed to do? External contracts or freight market?
You go to freight market.
Yeah, that's okay. That's where I was, and then I clicked on this, and it just tells me to set as GPS destination.
Down below it says take job.
And not for me.
You're too late, Sonic. I have forklift certified.
It might be because I don't have the right truck for it.
No.
That might be.
Which means I'm stuck doing quick jobs.
And this is not exactly a quick one. Because
it was the smallest one I could find. a lot of these are just like big ones with this area.
Mm. All right, if I take jobs,
time to get the job done.
Oh, I found the ferret macaroni video.
Then if you go hit escape, hit up at the top session, it should show me, yeah, use packaging, top right, freight market, Grand Canyon to Bakersfield.
Oh my god, they look so happy in the macaroni.
Dude, I kind of want to get Roxy a bin of macaroni.
I thought you said this was gonna. I thought you were looking for.
You gotta make sure they don't eat it though, because.
Well, I was doing an experiment here to see if. What's going on?
Oh my god, ferrets eat things they don't eat. They don't. They shouldn't eat just like ricochets.
No, actually, do you know that ferrets imprint on food in their first year of life? So if they don't eat something in the first year of life, they won't recognize it as food and won't eat it.
I don't know why it wouldn't. Oh. Fail to create the
company. Me on the other hand. Look at that child. I'm gonna eat that child.
I probably have to get off the frickin'.
Lucy's just eat things. They definitely shouldn't.
No, how
candle
do I,
wax looks really tasty.
How do I exit out of the menu?
What's
which menu?
Ferret. Feed a ferret pizza? No, please don't.
Here,
please don't feed a ferret pizza.
Unless you made like a specialty thing just for a ferret.
Unless it's a meat lover's pizza that's so meat lover that it's all meat and no other ingredients of pizza. As the and
trailer?
Also it's raw.
Or was it where I was?
It's where you were.
Yeah, there was a trailer there for me too when I did set GPS thing, but it wouldn't let me grab the trailer.
Drive safe.
Did you take the job or just set GPS to?
Set GPS because it wouldn't let me accept job.
Alright, at the front there, there is that trailer icon. You need to enter in that. It'll then show the job and then you go... click it, and then hit take job.
Pistachios.
Really? That's how I have to do it?
Give me a pistachio.
Oh, that pistachio here.
Thank you.
Oh, you're eating pistachios?
Dude, I'm glad we still have pistachios.
I got a honey.
Just make sure they don't mutate.
I don't know.
I gotta shell my.
Oh, don't worry. I have two dogs. I can save the world with my two dogs.
By the way, disaster. Not disaster. So we need to feed a ferret pizza. That was more of a joke. Okay. So with the. Session, if you hit escape, you go up to session, says fart bubble. You click that.
Don't click the fart bubble, it will explode.
The session named Fart Bubble.
I know, I'm just being a smart ass.
You can click my name and then say view and take the same job.
Yeah.
To make it easier. Now, once you're ready, then we'll head on out.
I don't understand one thing. Why are people talking about butts all the time when you could be talking about milkshakes?
Because milkshakes are more common and less cautious.
Right.
Dude, people want the wrong kind of shake. I want a milkshake. I don't want a butt shake.
That would be disgusting.
Unless it's a ferret shaking his booties music.
Oh, that would be very wholesome, and I would like that kind. Because it is a ferret.
I just realized I'm kind of like I'm
okie
kind
dokie,
of like
dokie.
A bottle.
Breaks
I'm,
over.
I'm like
liquor listening, but I can't type. Understandable disaster. Stay amazing.
I just realized I'm kind of like a can of soda because if you shake me up and then throw me into a dark room, I'm gonna let loose hell.
Oh. Okay.
Nobody do that. I don't like being dizzy.
No, don't give them shaken baby syndrome.
I'm
18
metal,
speed
like,
for
well,
life,
I
baby.
Yeah, but also you shouldn't shake electronics in general. You could unplug something.
I mean, nothing is unpluggable in me. I am.
You mean you're not module? You can't be upgraded, bro?
No. I still have organs.
Dude.
Are you keeping up there, Lags?
I forgot what I was gonna say.
No, Shmoopy. I know what you're gonna say.
God damn it, Blaster.
Turkey Slurpee.
Dude, that's so funny.
It is.
Jack, this vehicle has not been customized whatsoever, other than the, paint on it.
Oh, so you're still rocking, like, the 410 horsepower...
Yeah,
baby motor.
I don't know how to calibrate shit. I'm not a car person. I can't calibrate worth shit.
All right, left turn coming up.
Turn left.
Also, I figured out how to do a left and right turn signal.
Hey. Nice.
Now you're not a driver people hate. Good job.
Well,
you're not a Swift driver.
I didn't know what the button was.
Turn left.
And while I was trying to figure out how to turn my truck off, I found the button.
Dude, I just remember this video I saw where it was like, oh, footage of insert kind of car user actually using the turn signal. And it's like the
BMW.
Turn signal's going right, and then the car turns left, and it's like, oh.
Oh, that sounds Ferrari to me.
And I'm like, oh. I don't get it, but that's funny.
Tomorrow, I am going to order that hard drive and then clean my freaking room.
Nice.
Because every time after Christmas, I always have to clean my room because I either get a lot of shit to where I have to clean up, or my room just gets too messy.
Yeah, I try and clean up my room before Christmas, but, chaos, so it's still kind of a mess.
Oh, we got an elk crossing. Watch out.
I have a vacuum because I have a thing where I pick up my fingernails and sometimes... like a little bit comes off and I don't like stepping on them.
Hmm. Also, Blaster, why are you farting in me chat? I saw that.
I walk around barefooted a lot in my room. Like, actually, like, I don't think I ever wear shoes in my room.
Yeah.
But I hate the feeling of, like, stepping on dirt. Cause that just feels gross to, like, be standing on, like, hard, like, the hard floor and then there's dirt between your foot. In the floor, so I'm like, I keep my room clean.
My character's bed icon is almost fully blue.
You should not look into my closet. Uh-oh. My closet is a mess.
Are there skeletons in there?
No, the skeletons are under my bed.
I have a thing. I have a red thing on my screen. I think. Oh, I need to be serviced.
Yes. Did you crash?
Bump in the road.
See, this is why we call you Car Crash, because you crash a bunch of cars all the time.
No, that's
nice.
That's Draka.
I'm the Reaper in Mudblood server for a reason.
I would.
And I'm the fart bubble because that's what people. That's how Mud met me. In a way.
I don't know what kind of driver I'd be.
Well, you would get your BMNG and find out.
I don't know. I feel like, Shmoopy, I feel like you would drive a massive monster truck and be like, bitch, I need to go get Whataburger right now.
Dude, I drive like a giant like semi truck and then I come out and I'm like, hello, I would like milkshake, please.
Big massive Peterbilt rolls up. And this tiny little thing, little Rook shows up.
Pops out, and I'm like, hello.
With Roxy on your shoulder.
Yeah.
I was completely going the hops. Oh, Jesus Christ, Lags, we really need to get you a better motor.
I'm kind of stopping at a motel to sleep.
Ew.
I don't... I don't know how to get the freaking vehicle.
You're gonna wake up to like bed bugs eating your skin.
Don't for the have living quarters inside them?
Not all trucks.
Oh, here we go.
Yes. Not all.
Relieving pressure, blaster.
Okay.
Can you put a hammock in one?
Alright, now I have
built-in bunk bed.
I know, I'll put a hammock in.
Now the truck needs to be serviced.
You're gonna be looking for a wrench icon somewhere along the route. So that way you can go to it and get serviced.
Although last time I had a hammock, it actually split in half.
Last time I had a hammock, me and my older brother were sitting on one side of it, and my younger brother was poking his head outside the other one. It was one of those hammocks that have, like, the boards on either end, so it's, like, kind of like a flat
almost
panel
like a stretcher.
Of fabric. Yeah, so it's like a stretcher. So imagine this, like, we're both sitting on one side of it, and it's lifting up the inside of the hammock, and my younger brother's, like, poking his head outside the other side. We get up from the hammock, because we don't realize he's sticking his head out of the thing. And he swings down and just face plants into the rocks beneath the hammock.
Ow!
We didn't realize he was doing that. So we just like got up and we were talking and we like got up to go do something. And it's just, and we're like, oh.
Crunchy.
I remember this one time, you know, okay, so any of you know Omaha Steaks?
Yes.
No.
Okay. I used to order from Omaha Steaks a lot, good steaks and everything. And we always had like the dry ice and all that kind of stuff. And like,
oh, that's fun.
Really, really, really hard, like, styrofoam things that they had. Nobody else could break those down. So you know what I do? I said, listen, give me it. And then I get it, go out in the garage, and I put it down on like, and then I ground pound it, and the thing goes into like a million pieces.
Nice. So you did like the flip when you did the ground pound, right?
Yes.
Okay, good. It's a proper ground pound.
Yeah. So I did the ground pound, and I all I said afterwards, I said if that was like somebody's chest or something, they would actually look like toothpaste. So I had to clean styrofoam for like 30 minutes.
Dude, why would you destroy styrofoam? That's like a big mistake.
Missing.
I was 15.
You were a fool.
I was a child.
I'm glad I didn't know 15-year-old you.
Now that I did,
you would have blocked me.
I would be so mad at you breaking styrofoam.
106 miles an hour
so
in an 18-wheeler. I am loving this.
And it'd also be a waste of such a big piece of styrofoam that you could carve into something cool.
Now that I did stuff with my truck, I am now on the road.
Why would I want to carve styrofoam when I could
I
just
am
find
404 miles away now.
The free bones.
I haven't even left the town yet.
Goddamn lag.
Carve styrofoam into a ferret.
I had to repair.
SCPete is putting it down.
You can carve styrofoam into many things.
Also, little Rue,
yes?
I touched a little bit of this on Lucy's stream earlier. I am going to be creating a custom cosplay of something.
Uh-oh.
And I kind of want to make it, like, vigilante. Sort of a Batman meets Red Hood meets Solid Snake.
Right.
So, it's gonna take some doing, but I think I know about the aesthetics look I need, and a lot of the stuff I'll be looking for to base it on is gonna be like motorcycle armor, quote unquote.
Oh, hell yeah.
So it will be actually functional.
Yo.
You know, if someone wants to swing a baseball bat at me, well, you know what's gonna happen? Ricochet! Return to center!
Boink! And like when they're like, what? The time it takes for them to realize, oh no, he's wearing armor. You've already punched him in the face.
No, they hit me with a baseball bat, it bounces off. I'm the real deal, motherfucker.
I feel like even without armor, someone hitting you with a baseball bat would just return to sender and you're like, try me.
Return to sender, chicken tender.
I know somebody.
Oh, I actually want chicken nuggies. Go straight.
What?
Dude, I could go for like.
Could be somebody black and blue with three baseball bats.
Black and blue, and all aimed at you.
Anyway, so my proposal right now, 40 spicy Wendy's nuggets.
Oh, I just got an achievement, Powell's Trail.
Guess what? My tank is now half full.
Oh, you mean it's half empty?
Either or, it's the same.
No, it's not.
Depends if you're adding to or redacting from. Don't get me on the scale. Yeah, don't get me on the scale. Don't get me on the scale. Fuck the scale. Fuck the scale. Fuck the scale. I hate this fucking scale.
If you see a green light for the scale notification, you can just bypass it.
Yeah, that's what I was hoping for, and apparently I did not have to get scaled. Hey! Although that would have given a chance for you lags to catch up, because I am 312 miles away now. 311.
Well,
310.
465.
I've still been thinking about Domino's. I want to get the stuffed cheesy bread.
I'm so excited about food. I might just go get some bagels after this.
Bacon?
Well, go get some bagels, bitch.
Legs, you're gonna hate me right now, but I can't wait to get some pizza from this local pizza place that makes such good pizza. Like, best pizza I've ever had. And I've been to almost every state.
I wish there was an option for idle driving, so I could just go make myself a couple bagels.
The only reason I'm not talking about food right now is because I'm playing a very gory game.
Man. Yo, red
sauce.
Dude,
every time I see gore or something, I'm like, man, I really could go for some, like, chicken wings right now, I'm also looking at, like, a bunch of, like, dead demons or something.
Duly noted, like, so if we play that cleanup game, you're just gonna be thinking about barbecue sauce, got it.
Dude, there's literally a Wingstop next to me.
Yo.
Ooh, shit, F-150 on a Camaro.
Eat wings while playing that game. Oof.
I can stomach a lot of things.
What?
You gotta remember, this game has more than just alien guts and blood in it.
Yeah, I know, there's dirt and grime and all of that kinds of stuff. Which, Jack, you kind of missed this in Sky's stream when she was playing that, and I joined in. There's TNT and I blew her up.
Yes!
Oh, yeah!
Wait, did you yell Chipotle? Fuck! Wait station.
I don't think I did.
Then you didn't do it proper.
Called requisition janitor with the
yes.
I got to do it a couple.
Totally.
I got to do it a couple times.
Wait,
what? One time.
Bonk him.
One time the
fails
bucket
at saying Chipotle.
One time
you
the bucket.
You can't say Chipotle.
If he
one
failed
time
at saying Chipotle when blowing something up, bonk him.
God damn.
Let me speak!
Okay, sorry.
One time the bucket dispenser actually dispensed a TNT and me and her had to both run out of the room.
Ooh.
And then from then on after that, she took all the TNT.
Oh, damn it. Well, aren't you glad I wasn't in there then? Because I would purposely be hunting the TNT then.
There's only a limited amount and then it's all gone.
Yeah, that's
it's
why
no
I would
use
hunt it out first.
So if we play the Santa's Rampage DLC
yeah
part, yeah, be advised, Jackie will find TNT.
I will find
you
it
see,
all.
You should get the Deltarune explosion sound effect on your soundboard.
I need to.
I need to set up a soundboard.
Double nickel.
I have what I need. I just need to set it up.
All right, at 253-ish miles, you're probably gonna get hit with the weight station.
384.
Oh, speaking of weight.
That is nature's weight reduction.
I'm
here you go.
Ew. This is what I call a.
No.
It could have been worse. I could have done the other one.
No.
I'm not playing the tornado siren because we're supposed to have tornadoes.
But I was gonna say the northwest tornado siren, yeah.
Yeah.
I don't play northwest. I don't want to do that because if I do that and I hear and I'm like, wait, why is there a siren still going on after it ends? I'm like, uh-oh.
Oh no. I'm 224 miles away, cruising at 84 miles an hour and gaining speed.
Lucy, remember when you explained that portion of your character's backstory where they played that sound and then there was an actual tornado and such?
Yes, it was a very big one.
I pictured your character in the Cloudy of a Chance of Meatballs restaurant where there's not a ceiling because the food just falls. Like, I don't know why. I don't know why it was that restaurant, but you were there.
Well, no, it was like a Waffle House.
I thought you were talking about like an actual one in IRL, but then I remembered the scene in the movie. I haven't seen that in forever. I need to rewatch that movie again.
Dude, I love that movie.
All right, correct me if I'm wrong on this one. Speaking of movies and all that and Pixar, isn't the original Toy Story like 27 years old now?
1995.
God damn.
No. Is it? Yeah, I think so. Is it either 1995 or 1999?
Someone ask Siri. Or
so,
whatever smart person device you have.
Yeah, I mean, like, I have been like a few hundred feet away from an actual tornado while like driving away from it. That's pretty spooky. That's the only thing that can actually kill me.
I have not come across a weight station yet.
Well, I'm 187 miles away now from the destination.
Me and my family.
One thing in Viscera cleanup detail that they have that you'll find throughout some of the levels, laser welder. Basically a giant ass laser gun that can weld bullet holes together.
Nice.
Hey.
So we'll be looking for bullet holes to repair, huh?
Yep.
Dream. Take me on out to this town.
But, Shmoopy, you were saying something.
I was saying, my family narrowly dodged Hurricane Ian.
Diane, my
in Florida.
Ian still causing problems.
Yeah, like, we were, like, 100% expecting and prepared for, like, so, like, we were, like, in Orlando.
Barstow.
And we're like, oh, it's heading straight towards us. And so we drove up, like, I think it was, like, 40 minutes, maybe, like, an hour and a half or something up away from Orlando to an RV site that we were in before.
Time to do some sketchy shit.
Yeah. And we were there, and we were all, like, mentally preparing for, like, being hit by, like, the edge of it and such. But somehow, it, like, never hit where we were. So we were like, what? Where's the hurricane? But then when we come back in Orlando, it's like, oh, it just destroyed.
Hey, Jack, with how fast you're going, that's about how fast I go down a hill.
Oh, God. Apparently, there's, like, a tornado warning in a lot of places right now. Uh-oh.
Yeah.
It's not even winter time anymore. The entire country is just covered in warm.
Warm.
Lucky. It's still cold up here.
Well, how cold is it then? I mean, how...
Dude, it's cold down here too.
I don't know. I can't see the temperature. Oh no.
I was sweating today.
Dude, just ask Siri, like, hey, what temperature is it? She'll be like, it's too cool.
Oh, that's a bike cop. Wait, that's just a bike. Where's the cop?
I ate the cop. He was delicious.
They taste like bacon or sprinkled donuts?
Both.
God damn,
yo,
maple bacon
maple
donuts.
Bacon? Yo, maple bacon.
Never had maple bacon donuts.
You're a fake Canadian.
You're Canadian.
Never said I was Canadian.
Oh, yeah, fuck,
you're
I know.
Baker.
Are you a faker or a baker?
Vaguely.
You know what?
It's no use! Dude, Silver, stop yelling!
No,
we're in the house!
I like how as soon as Lucy did that, like a couple seconds before, I just see them open sound pad in the corner.
I am 95 miles away from destination.
Dude, I love sound pad.
Oh, shit, I gotta stop at the next gas station.
Yeah, I need to add more sounds because I need more.
I'm 229.
What the fuck is that? Oh shit! Tumbleweeds! Ah!
You need to get
Fucking hell,
Jackie. You still need to like clean record yourself yelling like Chipotle and Bush to make some sound redeems.
We'll get it one of these days. We'll get it one of these days. As for the Chipotle, more tumbleweeds, god motherfucking damn it!
Oh, dude, what if you made a sound redeem that's just like unintelligible Irish screeching?
I can make a screaming sound, I just have to go like...
Actually... You know what? The clip that Mudblood made of Beeman G, that would be about right because I went full Homer Simpson. It actually sounded like I screamed like Homer Simpson too. That moment Lags went tumbling down the hill.
Listen, I saw it was going downhill and I went YOLO.
You didn't just go downhill, you went down into hell.
Went downhill and I became a mixer.
Whoa!
Hey, I'm in Bakersfield. I have a friend out here.
Okay, so we make calzones.
Okay.
That's my idea. We make the calzones.
All right.
And
47
we make
miles
a
away.
Lot of them, and we eat them.
What do we put
and
in
that's
calzones?
The plan. We put extra pepperoni and extra cheese and also
I'm 185 miles away.
Can I make mine a seafood pizza calzone?
Yeah, we'll just have to make sure that, you know,
hell
like,
yeah.
They don't, there's no cross contamination. I'm gonna put olives and pepperonis and cheese in mine.
Oh, nice. It's
like a train.
I'm also gonna dip it in garlic.
I don't like black olives, so you can dig into yours, I won't touch it.
I will eat a bunch of olives.
Cool, just don't eat my dog that's named Olive.
No, I'm not gonna eat your dog.
Yeah, no, you're not at that restaurant.
Oh my god.
We're not in that country either.
No, we're in the unfortunate one. The unfortunate country. Yeah, because me and Lags, we're in Canada.
No.
Listen, I'm in Alberta and he lives out over in, Ontario?
No, I don't live in Canada,
oh,
for
shit.
Fuck's sake.
Another one. Another wreck.
No wonder you don't. You've never had a maple bacon bar.
I don't have...
Bar? We're talking about not doing it.
Free healthcare.
Damn, that's because you don't eat maple bacon bars.
It's scientifically proven that if you eat maple, you actually get free healthcare.
Yeah, we promise.
What about maple wood smoking chips?
Yes.
Yeah.
Wait, I wish there was like maple barbecue Pringles. I like Pringles. When I go to the store, I'm gonna get like 8 cans of Pringles. I'm not even joking.
I love Pringles.
Yes, you like Pringles and you're single.
I'm a single Pringle.
Hey, brother. Hey, sister.
Two, actually. all of us except Lucy and yeah, all of us except Lucy are single Pringles.
Damn, y'all
you
got no
dude,
bitches.
Hell yeah, I don't. No thanks. The only ones
I am
ever
not gonna follow
dogs,
up a comment on that,
girls.
Lucifer.
Oh shit, I didn't stop to get fuel, fuck.
Yeah.
Ow.
I am,
listen, I
5 miles away from the destination.
I am 130 miles away, and
M&Ms,
I just got the notification
I'm rolling
fuel.
They're like chocolate-covered pretzel M&Ms.
Speaking
they're
of
really good, but I'm trying to close it up.
Speaking of, chocolate-covered pretzel stuff, I found these, dark chocolate Reese's pretzels.
Whoa.
They're really tasty, and they're one of the few things I can actually eat that doesn't upset my stomach.
Oh, that's right, I got Reese's right here.
I got Reese's in my
yum drawer.
I'm the only goblin right now that can't fucking eat food right now because I'm driving.
That sounds like a you problem.
Dude, just pull over and grab a snack.
This is how it's gonna be IRL if like the three of us are in a car. I'm gonna be the one driving, you two are just gonna sit and eat.
Oh, hell no!
Do you have a license?
Jack, when I say I'd be the one driving, I'm talking about if it's just me, Shmoopy, and Lucy.
I'm getting my license, I'm gonna be the one driving.
License yet,
if it was us in the car, I'd be concerned about Lags driving, considering the fact that he just forgot to get gas.
You're not wrong!
You're not wrong, no. That is very dangerous.
I'd be like, hello, we're in the middle of a desert, and you forgot to get gas. We're going to die.
Oh, quite fuck.
Literally.
It's this parking space?
Ew, not that parking space. I don't know what that means.
The only place that I'm stopping in the middle of the desert is a gas station, and everyone gets $10 each so they can get snacks.
Yo, can I buy a stick of butter?
Yes.
Yeah.
I'm keeping an eye on my map. Oh, tumbleweeds!
Ooh, I think I'd probably get, like, gas station
Oh,
tequitos.
You're now just coming up through tumbleweeds? What the hell?
Yep. 85
I'll
miles.
Get it with the hot sauce.
Okay, what foods would you never get? But okay, obviously besides gas station sushi, but like, what foods would you never get at a gas station?
I would probably never get like
coffee.
Coffee.
That's a hard one.
Oh, this is gonna
I'm
be
not
tricky.
A coffee. I'm not a coffee drinker, so that's like the one thing I wouldn't get.
I wouldn't get a Monster
general.
Because
I, mean,
I don't like Monster.
No, you don't understand the assignment. I mean, if you
This is tight.
You obviously wouldn't get that on a normal day, but what's something that you would get normally, but at a gas station you would never buy?
Oh, you fucking invisible barriers.
If I'm going like that route, I would have to say definitely sausage. Actually, no, I don't like sausage regardless.
Wow. Are you kidding me?
Their breakfast sandwiches are actually pretty good.
You know what? Breakfast sandwiches, that's definitely one I went to a gas station one time and I had this like egg and like cheese and bacon croissant and I ended up spewing everywhere. It was disgusting.
Yeah. So here's the thing with like,
where's the gas station?
Here's the thing about gas station like breakfast is that it's like so hit or miss. It's either really good or you're gonna be sick. Like, it's such a gamble.
Exactly. Like, if I'm stopping at like a Love's or something, like I just get like the tenders or something because I think they got okay tenders.
You can't really mess up chicken tenders. I mean, you could, please don't, but it's really hard to.
How odd, I ran a red light and yet I didn't get. Oh, never mind.
There's the gas
station chicken tenders are really good.
Okay, Lex is not driving us.
Yeah.
There's no traffic on the road. Jack's ignoring the red lights too.
Yeah, but he at least won't get us killed.
He can kick our butts if we tell him to not drive, so.
Along with that, if I know it's a residential area, I am honking like mad.
Dude, did you guys know that Usain Bolt can't legally run in a school zone? He's too fast. He can't.
Alright, so this is what I mean by it's this parking place.
But yeah.
I have to go around all of this with the trailer.
Ew! Dude! As someone who drives around with a rig as a night ride, dude, this is gross. Ew.
Ooh, you know what? Gas station hamburgers can be a huge hit or miss, too.
That's true. Dude,
yeah.
There are so many hit or miss foods where it's like, you can't tell it's terrible but just by looking at it, and you won't know until you bite into it or you get food poisoning within the next 40 minutes of after eating
exactly.
It.
Exactly. And but, I know if I'm like, because I've had stuff that's good but also give me food poisoning at the same time. Because I remember one time I was eating this like one thing or something. I was like, oh, this is actually pretty good. And then I just start going everywhere.
Yeah. Do you guys have that oddly specific thing that you're like, why does this make me feel sick or like gross, but nothing else in this same category makes me feel gross? It's not an allergy. It
just certain
that's how I feel with
mushrooms.
Like sodium heavy stuff.
Mushrooms. Oh,
certain mushrooms. No. It's like it's the canned mushrooms.
Oh,
certain
no.
ones I'm okay with, but other ones I like feel genuinely sick from.
So can you not have like canned mushroom soup, or is it just
canned
straight
mushroom
up mushrooms that are canned?
Certain mushrooms that are canned, it just
okay.
does not go well. But canned
Why
mushroom soup
canned
is fine.
Mushrooms. Okay, good. That means you're okay to eat my favorite food. For whatever reason, like, I can't have the Dairy Pure brand of milk, but every other milk has never made me feel gross. It's just that brand. And I don't know why. It's like, I don't know if it's like, because, like, I don't know if it's like, oh, they use more hormones in their milk or something, or there's just like something extra in it, but for whatever reason, only that brand of milk makes me feel like icky after. And then also Costco mac and cheese, like the kind that you get in the tin and you put in the oven, that has the same effect on me, so I'm guessing they must use Dairy Pure in it or something. But like, that is like the only food that I've eaten that's like, ah yes, this is making me actively feel sick.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna wait here for lag.
Food poisoning from a Taco Bell taco, but that's a different thing entirely. That's just like a one-off. Oops.
So okay, so that one like gas station that I go to like a lot, the one called All Subs or whatever, they have really good food, and I'm gonna name off their menu because it's good food.
Okay. Tell us the hits.
Yeah. Okay. So the beef and bean burrito is pretty good.
Beef and bean burritos are so good.
And then they got the chili and cheese burrito. It's like chili peppers.
Ooh.
Beef and cheese chimichangas, and then chicken chimichangas.
Oh yeah. Wait. Let me ask you this: is it like the kind of beef where it's like ground beef, or is it like pulled beef? Like
ground.
You know what I mean?
Ground.
Cool.
Yeah. They also.
I mean, either
would have
been great, but I needed that information. That's very important information.
And the chicken, all the chicken stuff they have could be either regular or spicy, so you know, good. They got jalapeno corn dogs.
Oh, yo, what the hell? That sounds
they
so
got,
good.
Yeah, and then they got chicken and cheese fajitas, and then
oh, I see you, Lex.
And then they got something called a fat boy taquita.
I hate jalapenos.
Damn.
You scud.
I can't. Imagine. I'm not kidding when I say that, because I cannot stand smelling them.
By the way, Legs,
if
you
like
choose...
a 12-year-old right now.
If you choose to take the maximum where you want it, parking job, you are going to hate it.
Yeah.
I always
keep listening off the hits, so I wanna know.
Where it's going to be in comparison.
They also got egg rolls, pork or chicken. They also got potato munchers that are jalapeno.
What the hell are potato munchers? Please explain.
I don't know either.
Please, do they elaborate on the menu? I need to know.
Oh, it's like a deep fried stuffed potato that's kind of like fried pickles, and it's got like
Whoa.
Jalapeno in it.
Oh, what the?
It,
I'm kicking they got down chicken your door sandwiches. We're going to Allsup's to get the potato munchers.
You're not gonna make it like that, Legs, unless you just did the pull-in.
Of course, chicken sandwich. They got catfish baskets. You can get a bucket of catfish.
Ooh.
A basket. Chicken strips, obviously.
Hey, Legs. A little hint. You're gonna have to do a complete 180.
Do they have fries to go with the chicken strips?
They have potato wedges.
Okay, that's allowed. That's allowed. As long as you have potatoes, something on the side of your chicken tenders or nuggets, that is legal.
Oh, easy there, Legs. You about taking out the damn side of the trailer.
Now I want tater tots and chicken nuggets.
Yeah. Okay. And then they have deep fried pizza.
That is the most American thing I've ever heard of, besides deep fried Twinkies.
Yeah. Deep fried Oreos.
That feels less American than Twinkies, like...
Oh, shit, curb hopping already.
I always curb hop, I don't know what you're on about.
And then they have,
oh my god,
they have,
are you my family friend who drives over curbs?
My dad always does it. Anytime he drives down the hill into the parking lot, he always has to hit the one corner.
Dude, oh my god, we have this, like, family friend, as in, the entire family... They're all family friends, but the entire family, medians don't exist. They will just...
Yeah.
We don't take rides from any of them anymore.
Like, figure all that out.
What?
They also have, hot dogs that are with sausage, so it's a sausage hot dog.
What?
And then they have cheeseburgers.
Well,
they
I have
barbecue beef sandwiches.
Can I get a chili dog there?
I have explosives.
No.
So. Also,
they also have kettle wings.
I have that at level 2. Long
they have
my favorite
burgers too, and fuel
economy. They also have sausage on a stick, potato wedges, like I said, jalapeno sausage on a stick, mini tacos, Mexican burger.
Fucking hungry.
Yeah.
Elaborate, please.
Okay, so mini tacos are just tiny tacos.
Mm. No, what I mean, what's inside? Taco is just term, like, that's like saying like mini burger. It's like, oh, well, what's in the burger? A burger.
Burger.
Is it beef? Is it pork? What kind of chicken? What kind of taco was it, mate?
It's just like beef and cheese.
Oh, okay.
Let me see.
And then the Mexican burger is just like seasoned and has Mexican stuff in it, like jalapenos. And they got the Mexican corn
flavor?
Hot dog.
Hey, hold on.
Yeah.
Hold on. Jack, if you press escape or your menu button to
they also have tamales.
The view the thing, you should be able to see the option to click skills up in the
top. You can buy a lot of them.
Right.
Have you ever gotten tamales at Costco? They come in a big bag and they're frozen, and then you could just put them in. If you have a little steam cooker for your microwave, you just put them in there with like a little splash of water, and it microwaves in like 2 minutes, and it's so delicious. And during the holidays, they have like green chili cheese ones. So good.
I'm about to make you and Jack like get really hungry after this one. Jalapeno poppers.
Yes. Habanero poppers.
Very good.
And then they have cheese sticks.
Of course. Yo, cheese sticks.
And
oh
here's
God.
The thing about their cheese sticks.
I bought 2 boxes of mozzarella sticks today.
No, here's the thing about their cheese sticks. It has like melted, like I think white cheddar in it and like chicken in it. It's really good.
What the hell? Please kidnap me.
I think it also has ranch.
So, was this Allsup's? I'm finding the nearest Allsup's and I'm going there.
Well, yeah. And then the breakfast menu. I haven't even touched the breakfast menu.
Oh my god! Breakfast menu. Okay, I'm sitting down for this one.
Okay, so they have the sausage egg cheese burrito.
Ooh.
They got the ham egg and cheese burrito.
Ooh, do they have bacon?
Oh my god!
Yes. Wait.
Yes. Chat. We are hitting just about every single taste bud today or tonight.
Y'all can just deal
We're
with
sorry.
That. I'm talking to everyone. I'm talking to the child.
Did you start a job, Jackie, or no?
I have not yet.
Okay. And then they have steak, egg, cheese burrito, sausage go ahead, burrito, ham burrito.
Get a job, take it, and then I'll be able to view and take same job.
They have biscuit with sausage in it.
The thing is, Jack, I have to rent a truck because it won't let me use my own unless if
they have biscuit with bacon and egg in it.
I see.
Oh, they have croissants with sausage and egg.
That's partway through making a breakfast BLT then.
Yeah. And then they have a breakfast BLT in here.
Yes.
And then they have hash brown with sausage in it.
Good.
Can we just go out to eat like breakfast together or something? Breakfast is literally my favorite meal time.
If we go out to breakfast, I really hope they have a trucker platter. No pun intended because of what I do, but the last trucker platter I had, it was a steak and eggs based with a half and half of biscuits and gravy with hash browns that were waffle cut fries.
Whoa.
Those were really good. Cup of soup, and it also had a 3 pancakes, French toast, and there was one other thing. I can't remember what it is.
Delicious flavor.
And this was all one plate for one person.
Whoa, dude, I'm ordering that, and I'm gonna have leftovers for like 3 days. It's gonna be awesome.
Oh, I can eat the whole damn thing, and the steak is a 12-ounce New York strip.
Whoa.
Oh, Shmoopy, I'm gonna send you a picture of some of the food. This is like what the food looks like.
Dude, you're gonna have to make me go make food now. And yeah. I'm okay with that because like, all I've had today to eat. Okay, well, actually, I have been eating today. I almost forgot. I have been eating okay today. It's just the brain forgot words.
Shit, where'd you
food
go, Matt?
Good.
Matt Truckee town.
Dude,
I believe it's in California.
And here's the thing, Shmoopy. Here's the thing.
Top.
I just wanted to make the noise.
Oh, I see you.
Nice.
Also, the most expensive thing there is like $3.
Oh my god, dude. Can we
just
go
to closer to Reno?
I'm pretty sure there's one near you. You could probably look it up.
Oh,
just
yo,
don't dox yourself on stream.
I know. Oh man. There's one right next to me where I live on made up address here.
Mm. No, you said quick jobs?
I need to memorize that
external
address
Walter
White says when he's like in that clip of him where he's like
go to job market.
He like says his address or whatever.
And then freight market.
<That's> so funny.
Oh, yeah. I just thought of something.
Did we want to
chicken Alfredo mozzarella flavor sticks?
What the hell?
Can you guys stop talking about food for like 5 fucking minutes?
We're trying to get one more job in. Please.
Did we want to do one that's like fairly close or one that
do you want to deliver
a
chips?
Very far distance.
We want to have one that is not a very far distance, only because it's going to be the last raw since I'm at an hour and 20 minutes on the clock, and it's 1:32 in the morning for me, and I still have tomorrow to go through.
For a second, my brain was like, oh my god, it's 1 a.m., but I was just used to being on the same time as Jackie for, like, 2 months, so now I'm like, oh wait, no, it's only, like...
Wait, Shmoopy, we would be the ones in the backseat that are constantly asking to stop at different restaurants. Can we go to that place? I want food.
Oh, mixed tank from Truckee to Oakland.
No. $7,700. You just need to like instead of asking them constantly if we want to pull over and eat, you just subtly make them realize that they're hungry by being like, "Oh man."
There was a long distance one that was like 36,000.
Yeah, that is one of my powers. I can make people hungry.
Yeah.
By the way, SCPete is in action.
Yo, like if I'm if I'm hungry in the car, I feel really awkward to ask, like unless I'm like really hungry and I can tell the other people are hungry, I won't be like, hey, can we pull over and eat? I'll just kind of like imply it and kind of make it so then they have the idea.
Dude, we're manipulating people into going to get food, hell yeah.
No, but like, it's not like I'm doing it for bad reasons. I feel awkward about asking, so I'm just like, I'll just like mention
yes,
stuff and
SCP,
then they start thinking
power
about it, and then they're like, oh man, wait a minute, I'm hungry. You guys want to pull over and get food? And I'm like, yeah, that sounds like a good idea.
Yes. We are.
Oh, shit.
Sneaky like that.
Yeah.
Listen, I'm not even pulling out my biggest weapons because I could mention like the kinds of pizzas that I like and people would be like, fuck you.
Dude.
Okay, I know you can't have this, Lucy, but there's a local pizza place here that has a seafood pizza where they use Alfredo sauce as the cheese.
Why did it tell me to go all the way this way and then tells me I have to like make I have to like turn completely
also
around?
I love how Domino's uses garlic seasoning on their crust.
Like, oh my god, I fucking love it.
Dude, it's like, okay, listen, your pizza, if you're gonna have a good pizza, you gotta make sure it has a good crust. That's how you know you got a good pizza.
Okay, and like the thing about Domino's is when it comes to your house nice and hot, it's like the cheese is just perfect.
Dude, I have a Domino's within walking distance from my home. So like when we order pizza, it's literally like the cook time and then not even a 2 minute drive, like
Jackie being expert driver by the way.
Like, listen, like the most time it takes them.
The
like
GPS is not always right. I'm sorry.
The thing that takes up the most time for them delivering the pizza is exiting the like the the parking lot of the like area. Cause it's like what's it called? Where there's like a bunch of different like businesses in one area, but they share a parking lot. Like, what is that called?
A complex.
Strip mall?
Yeah, it's a complex.
A plaza.
A plaza, thank you. No, it's not a complex. It's a plaza. So, like, it's in a plaza, so then they have to exit the parking lot, and then they literally, like, drive across the street, and we're there, and it's like,
oh, yeah, so you get it, like, extra fresh.
Think of how it is with me. I work at McDonald's and I can literally walk down the street to go to Subway.
Oh, this thing does have a Jake break.
Oh, yeah.
Subway.
I'm glad
fresh.
You're walking to better food places.
I've only done that once.
Lame.
I only get a 20 minute break. If I had like a 40 minute break, yeah, I'd
wait,
go to.
How long do you work?
It varies. Every
you
4 hours.
You get like a 30 minute break, not a 20 minute.
Every 4 hours is a 20 minute break.
Oh, that's weird.
Remember, working laws may be different per state.
Yeah.
Also, Lags, I am just gonna hold off until you get close to me, and then I'm gonna hammer down.
Oh, my driver's getting fucking tired again.
Shmoopy, I'm having to hold off on all the food I want to talk about because everyone's gonna fucking yell at me.
You guys can talk now. We're pretty much driving.
Yep.
Pistachios are amazing.
I like
Lucy.
Pistachio butter.
Yeah. I was gonna say real quick, peanuts covered in chocolate and sprinkles, those are pretty good.
Dude.
Also, Lags, you need to look into it once you get a sleeper, because then once you park in a place, you'll be able to just sleep in your truck and not have to go to a hotel.
Yeah, that'd be nice.
I love chocolate bars with peanuts in them are really good.
Yes.
Also, dude, Butterfingers? So good.
What if paydays were made of almonds?
Hold on. Back to Butterfingers. I don't like their new recipe.
They change recipes?
Yeah. When I was a kid, they tasted so much better. They don't taste as like they used to.
I think that's just called nostalgia.
No, they really don't taste like they used to.
Because that's called nostalgia.
I'm going to listen to restaurants all... I'm going to list all the restaurants that are literally right next to door to each other by my work. Oh my god.
I love Butterfingers. Butterfingers might be my favorite candy bar now.
KFC, Wendy's, McDonald's, Taco Bell, Arby's. There you are, legs! Now I can hammer down!
I like Reese's. I like Reese's and M&M.
Yeah. Dude, I love Whoppers. Whoppers are so good.
Oh yeah, Whoppers.
Dude, Whoppers are really good, but like, what's up with like the trick-or-treat tiny version?
ISX power!
I got a whole bunch during trick-or-treating on Halloween, and like, I feel like a third of them were like, either like stale or like squishy soggy, and I'm like, how? You are packaged, how? What?
Jack, I was
they probably don't. How fast are you going? 97. That's considered like garbage to most people.
Yeah, lags.
But no.
ISX 15 for the win.
I don't know how to calibrate. Oh, hey, I have a sunroof.
Okay, think about this: a payday bar, but instead of peanuts, it's cashews.
That sounds really good.
Like saying, "I don't know how to calibrate," and then they say, "Oh, I have a sunroof."
What's your favorite holiday treat?
I really like... I have to really think about this one.
Okay,
I like sugar cookies.
Sugar cookies are one of my favorite kinds of cookies, and like, it sounds dumb, but they're so good because they're so simple.
We hijacked this broadcast and talking about food.
Nah.
Sorry, guys.
It's a normal land of shenanigans. What do you expect?
There's no laws here.
Yeah, randomness definitely is here.
Yeah, there's no laws here. I'm gonna fucking stab
someone. No. There are some basic laws.
There's also still morals here. Like, what?
I was gonna shank someone with a candy cane.
That's funny.
We're past Christmas, so unfortunately we cannot. And Fire Scale, hello! And with a cheers, nonetheless. Separate to grab something to drink, whether it be Shot Glass Bug, Sipping Cup, or in my case, a Man in a Can, which is Mountain Dew Amp. Bottoms up.
My favorite holiday treat is peppermint bark.
Ooh.
I know you showed me all the ones you have.
And then right behind it, it's, what's it called? The bird.
This corner's sharp, like, coming up, watch out.
Covered in, like, I don't remember what it is. It's like chocolate. Sometimes it's chocolate, sometimes it's
actually, double sharp corner, watch out.
Hey,
cutting it, NASCAR!
Can I take some peppermint bark off your hand there?
No. I'll bite your hand.
God damn it, Lucy!
I didn't get any this year.
Well, you are an adult, aren't you?
They didn't have any at my freaking store.
Okay, well...
Oh, Crimson? It's doing alright. We are, we're in...
Pocky?
ATS?
What? I'm not thinking of Pocky, I'm thinking of...
The bread sticks with, like, caramel or whatever on them? Pocky.
No, I'm talking about bird's nests, like freaking pretzels covered in like the holiday treat, you know? They look like a bunch of sticks, like, scrangled up together. There's sometimes nuts in them. They're often covered in, like, chocolate or caramel or, like, stuff like that.
No idea what never you're talking about.
Yeah, I know exactly what they're talking about.
Damn, you guys have never been to a grandma's house, have you?
Well, we
I used to make that
grandma.
Stuff. What are you talking about?
We don't have
Oh god, now I feel really old. What the fuck?
I don't have a grandma or my grandma.
Oh, hey, legs,
exist.
I see you on the map.
Yeah, I see you two zooming right on by.
I didn't get to have good grandma food.
I haven't heard of them, or it's not a Christmas tree.
I've never been fat. Oh, okay, well, that's not true. I mean, I am fat, but I meant like I've never been fatter from grandma.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's a holiday treat, or at least I've only ever had it during the holidays when we'd go over to grandma's house. So,
could be
like, that's true. I just my brain just connects it to like Christmas and holidays because.
I know, Crimson, I may be younger than you, but I don't know, it's old-fashioned, that's it, old-fashioned. Also, I feel like I am in the industrial complex around an area near my actual house.
He's younger than you, but he's actually older than you.
Younger chronologically, older in race. Okay.
Dude, yes. despite being like the youngest person in this group, sometimes I feel like I'm more mature than most. I'm always the youngest in all of my circles. Like, I don't think I know anyone from in VR chat that's like younger than me. Mostly because like when I like met people, I was like 18, and I'm like, I don't want to befriend a 17-year-old or younger. But I'm like, dude, how am I younger than like some of you people, and I'm more mature? Like, this is so weird.
I mean, I have told you about my accidents involving the stove.
Yeah, I'm like, what? Or like, some of the people I know in like this my friend's Splitco's group, like, I'm like, bro, are you 14?
Oh God.
What are you doing?
Another one of these. Lags, do not push me.
Uh-oh.
Lags, if you push him, I'll give you five theoretical dollars.
Lags, I have a question. What snacks do you have to offer for trade from my peppermint bark?
Lemon cream cookies?
Mm.
1 pound worth?
I don't know what those taste like. I know lemon's really good, but I'm like, what?
It's basically like lemon cream in between like two vanilla cookies.
Oh.
Basically think of a lemon cream Oreo between, but instead of chocolate Oreos, it's the golden Oreos.
Yes, and they're
oh my god, disaster. I love Haichu.
They're also softer cookies, but they are dollar store brand.
I like the strawberry Haichu or the mango one, disaster.
What else you got? I want to know my options.
Hey, spoken like me.
Kettle corn popcorn? Honey roasted peanuts?
Before you only say anything, it's because I have to reposition myself.
I have a bunch of granola bars, but those are my breakfast.
I'm not taking anything. Well, actually, it'd be like a trade, so...
I have a orange chocolate thing.
Orange chocolate thing?
Yeah, it's a circular ball of chocolate that tastes like orange. And if you smash it on a tabletop, it's already pre-cut into like orange slices.
Oh yeah, I know what Lags is talking about.
Oh, yeah. The name of them. Oh, those. For a second, I thought you were talking about, like, you know those freaking, like, strawberry-filled, like, chocolate treats? But it was orange?
Yeah,
no. And I'm like, ew. And then you're like, oh, no, it's, like, the orange slice ones. I'm like, oh, I've seen those, but I've never had one.
I like the sour watermelon slices.
I'll trade you some fictional peppermint bark for your, fictional, orange chocolate thing.
They also have them in raspberry, if I remember correctly.
I also have three chocolate bars that are caramel, and they're Ghirardelli brand.
Ooh, I have a bunch of those.
I got the Ghirardelli peppermint bark, baby.
I have a bunch of the caramel.
Oh, you
ones.
Got the. Oh my god, those are good.
I also got the William Samoa peppermint bark.
I like the William Afton.
I like the homemade peppermint bark. The homemade peppermint bark.
Dude, I want to make my own peppermint bark. Dude.
The man behind the slaughter. The man behind the chocolate.
Lucy, that reminds me of a story. My younger brother was saying like, oh yeah, finesse cool and such. And my younger sister was like, for some reason, trying to like gatekeep him out of being a FNAF fan, like, do you know enough? Despite the fact that she's not even one, like, she's just like, have you ever played a game? Have you blah blah blah? And then, like, we were discussing it, and
she
I think
there
she was saying, like, dude, security purchase $20 right now, but
I know, I
Oh, hell yeah. But, I want to play it. It seems really stupid. But, we were talking about it, and my sister was like, older brother would be more of a fan than you, because he's played the games. And I'm like, actually, he doesn't like it, because the creator, William Afton, apparently is a bad person.
I'm getting the fuck out of here.
My younger brother turns to me, it's like William Afton, as in the fictional serial killer. And now we're just an inside joke of like, yes, William Afton, fictional serial killer, in parentheses, older brother hates.
I want to see how Lag does with this, so.
I said William Afton, Scott Coffin.
Nope, wrong button!
Oh.
Meant to hit number two, so I have a big view.
Dude.
Ah!
FNAF is cool, but also is so stupid.
Definitely gets along the cringy side.
Oh yeah, it is totally like one of those things where it's like, screw you, I know it's cringy, but it's funny.
Hey, Lags? Remember, your truck turns a lot quicker than that trailer in the first degree, and then in the second degree, it's the other way around. So.
Dude, wait. Brain.
So, at first, your trailer doesn't move hardly at all, but then when you get further out, your trailer will move a lot faster.
No, the scariest thing in Security Breach is when the game breaks, and then you have a Gigamonti after you, where he just knows where you are and will not stop chasing you.
Yeah.
That's the scariest thing.
The only game that genuinely terrified me and I feel like was like actually really good was like Pizza Simulator, because that shit was actually really hard.
What? Pizza Sim what?
What?
Pizza Simulator, what?
Well, no, it's not an actual pizza simulator. It's actually really fucking scary. It comes off as like, oh, look, a cute game and all that, and then it's not.
And then it's like, ooh, the office section. I hear the office sections are like the worst part of that game.
They're hard.
Yeah, they're hard, but I also have heard that that's like the least favorite part of it. That's everyone's least favorite part of the game.
I'm on a timer. My character is getting tired.
Game is scarier than all the others.
Tell your fictional game character to man up and just stay awake for 5 more minutes.
Okay, but like the thing about Security Breach is now we have Gregory memes. It's like, Gregory, why the fuck are you on the balcony? Get down from there.
Don't you dare.
And you saying the balcony reminds me of Ace Ventura, Pet Detective. Oh god, they will never know the Ace Ventura.
I have not seen Ace Ventura in so long. I saw the child one.
Oh. Dude, we don't talk about that one.
I love the Glamrock Freddy avatar I have in VR chat. Because not only is it quest and PC, but it also has things like I can open up the chest and people can actually sit in it, and I'm like, that's so cool.
I get it.
I love it. Also, it makes me think of that time. Makes me think of that time Jackie had stream muted, and we were just making jokes about Guy Fieri.
Oh, fuck's sake.
Yes, that was like one of the first. That was like the second time I met you when we were just talking about like killing children.
That was like our second conversation ever. It was just so cursed.
Yes, it was funny.
By the way, Lags, how did SCPete look?
It was
in
so
your
cursed.
View?
I'm glad the stream was muted. It wasn't, like, anything, like, controversial. It was just sounded like something Twitch would be like, get out.
I mean, it's definitely faster than my vehicle.
Yeah.
So, is my character, like, gonna pass out or something, or what?
Very possible.
Oh my god.
Also, is the damn gate... Motherfucker.
Screw you, gate. Somebody. Just run through it. Okay, William Afton. Crash through the fence!
It'll be funny!
Do it. Do it.
No one will know. Who's gonna stop you, Sonic the Hedgehog?
Who's gonna stop you, the police? I don't think so.
I am the police.
How'd that work out for you, Lags?
Didn't work.
Dude. My younger brother, I think he watched just a highlight reel of it, but he knows some of the jokes for the, like, the Sonic fan dub. So now every time anyone says one or, don't fall, we just kind of look at each other like... We just, like, look at each other because we both are thinking the same thing.
Hey.
It's funny.
We have a bunch of inside jokes that nobody gets also, because everyone's lame.
Read the book.
Nobody will. Everyone's too busy looking at guys' butts, which, why would you do that?
One day I'm just gonna... I'm waiting to kidnap Android to commit epithet erase, but also at some point, I'm just gonna kidnap Jackie to do it.
What?
Yeah.
Yeah, just kidnap you to watch epithet erase, and then we can, then you can be in on the memes. Cause it's like literally my favorite thing, and nobody knows what it is. Lucy only knows what it is because I'm like, watch this or I'll kill you, and then they did.
Yeah, I've been held hostage.
I've been holding them hostage. I also bought them the book for Christmas because they're like, oh man, I don't have enough money. I'm like, just screw it. And I just threw $15 at them.
I only accepted it because I know that's one thing that would have made them really happy. Plus, I actually like the book.
Yeah.
I'm literally, what the fuck is going on? Oh, it's a guy loading boxes. I'm like, what the fuck?
Honk at him, it'd be funny.
What is that response. You're doing, Jeff?
I'm just finding a dark space to park SCPete at the end of stream.
Oh wait, I'm dumb. For a second, I was like, what?
Well, me
why
too.
Can't I hear the? Why can't I hear the sound?
Are you
game?
Fucking kidding me, you son of a dick?
Sorry.
What'd he do? I turned on.
They ran right into the side of me.
Oh my god.
This is why we do not trust you driving.
Lags, this is why you're not driving the. This is why you're not driving.
You are not driving the $200,000 motorhome.
Oh, I think No. I don't even trust myself with that.
I don't even trust you in a soccer mom car.
I don't trust you in a Ford Pinto.
I don't even know what that is.
Here's the thing: I don't trust my mother driving a soccer mom van. You want to know why? Because she almost drove it into a freaking swamp.
What? I don't trust your mom.
Yeah, your mom sounds cringe.
Yeah, she threw away a Game Boy. She can go jump in a swamp or something. I don't know. What does she want to do in her free time?
She's a swamp dumper. That's gonna be my new favorite insult to use on people. You're a swamp dumper.
A swamp dumper?
Yeah, it makes no sense. And I like it. It's like, dude, oh, this guy doesn't like Cheetos, he's probably a swamp dumper.
You should say something like, oh man, you're such a Waluigi Whopper, and they're like, what?
Anyways, everyone, we are coming to end of stream here, an hour and 45 minutes, almost on the dot. So.
Peace.
Yeah, we're gonna be heading off for this morning for me, since it's almost 2 in the morning. And we're also going to find somebody to raid. Reason being?
Because
we can. And lags.
Sky is streaming.
Gotta get one headbang in.
No, of course.
Oh, I see you, bitch.
I'm wondering.
Don't mess with me. I have the power of. Never mind. I died.
I'm looking around, seeing who is online. Is there any suggestions that are below 10 viewers?
Oh, I was gonna say Sky, and then she's at 15, so no.
I see Lunarian Clash.
I was gonna raid someone, but there was nobody on at the time.
Oh, what game do you wanna do? Because I bet we can scroll around in a game and just raid someone random that has, like, nobody.
Yeah, I mean, fair, we could do that.
I was gonna suggest VR Bun, but he has 11 viewers.
Yeah.
Pick a random game, Jack.
Just any game, really.
Shinobi, what are you feeling of watching? Something horror? Something...
There's a couple of, there's a couple of Pokemon games being streamed where they're like, I have 5 viewers or something.
I'll recheck my list and see what all I have available.
Yeah, everyone I was watching before, dude, I had like 3 people streaming at the same time that I'm like, I want to watch them out of support. And then I'm like, damn it, there's literally 3 people at once going.
Lunarian is streaming Phasmophobia, I will say that.
How much people?
Like 1.
They are perfect.
Perfect.
They are the perfect test subject.
They're the perfect subject for a sacrifice.
Yes.
Alright, Lunarian Clash.
Through the hot run, Jackie.
So you know what? We're gonna do it with the radio voice. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, lads, lasses, attack helicopters, battleships, and tanks. My girls, my guys, my unidentifieds. If you enjoyed yourself, hopefully, we can see you on the next adventure. Hashtag here comes a horsepower. That way they know exactly who is raiding them. Along with that, if you want to join a lot of shenanigans, then you do exclamation point Discord just as Lag's done here in the chat. That's the link for the land of shenanigans, so you can be here anytime, on time, every time, whenever a stream of myself or any of my friends decides to go up. Plus, you can hang out with me or any of the ones like the goblins themselves. We got the 3-piece here. So, till next time, sleep soundly, dream endlessly, and I'll see you on the next adventure. Damn it, Draka.
That was
That's not Draka.
That was Lucy.
Fucking hell.